The history of Erdinger Weissbräu, the largest Weissbier brewery in the world today, began in 1886. After changing hands twice, former managing director Franz Brombach took over the brewery in 1935. The brewery has remained in the hands of the Brombach family ever since. Werner Brombach has been managing the company since 1975. Hello, and a warm welcome to Erdinger Weissbräu. In the film you're about to see, we'd like to give you a brief idea of how we brew our beer. Afterwards, you'll be able to follow the path of the beer as it is being brewed. Despite advances in technology and the high standards of quality we enjoy today, four ingredients, wheat and barley malt, hops, yeast, and water, are still used in brewing good traditional beer. Malt provides beer with its full taste and color. Only the best barley and wheat malt can guarantee the unique taste of Erdinger Weissbiers. The grains contain carbohydrates, protein, and vitamins. First of all, the brewing cereals, barley, and wheat are malted. This means that they are left to germinate, then dried in a kiln oven before being used as coarse grain malt for brewing. The brewing process itself begins in the brew house. Coarse grain malt is mixed with the brewing water in large stainless steel mash tubs and then heated to various temperatures. In this way, insoluble starch can be released from the cereals and converted into maltose by the enzymes contained in the cereals. Erdinger Weissbräu has its own deep well, which forces brewing water up 156 meters through many layers of rock to the surface. The characteristic taste of Erdinger Weissbiers owes a great deal to the high quality and purity of the water drawn from its own well. This infusion of malt is known as wort and is separated from the empty seed husks, or so-called malt husk, in a refinement vat. The insoluble components, or draft, drift down to the bottom of the refinement vat and form a kind of filter. After the wort has flowed down through the natural filter of draft and into the brewing pan, it is boiled together with hops to form a concentrated mixture. Hops are the soul of beer. When it comes to brewing Erdinger Weissbiers, only the very finest aromatic hops are selected from the neighboring Hallertau, the largest single hops growing area in the world. To guarantee a consistently high quality of this brewing ingredient, Erdinger Weissbräu does not use anything other than hops grown by carefully selected and independently monitored suppliers. The most valuable part of the 7 meter high plants to be harvested are the flower clusters, or umbels. They contain lupulin, a substance responsible for the taste and relaxing effect of the beers. Water evaporation leads to the desired concentration of original wort, which is regularly checked by the brewmaster. It was in the beginning as it is now. The traditional Bavarian purity law has continued to guarantee that no other ingredients may be used to brew beer apart from malt, hops, water, and yeast. And we, the master brewers of Erdinger, will always uphold that promise. A stringent system of quality control accompanies the brewing process from start to finish. Our highly modern laboratory is used to monitor the consistency of each component at each stage of the brewing process, which, as you can see, is the case here with yeast cultures. In this way, we are able to meet the high standards of quality we set ourselves and can guarantee that our beers always meet the high levels of quality our customers demand. Before it can be fermented, the wort must be purified in a sedimentation tank. A whirlpool is used to separate out protein particles and other cloudy components. The wort is then cooled. In the fermentation cellar with its 64 fermentation tanks, each holding 125,000 liters, our special top fermented yeast converts the maltose of the wort into alcohol and fizzy carbon dioxide. Brewing yeast puts life into the beer. It converts the maltose into natural carbon dioxide and alcohol. Adding a Weissbräu grows its own pure and high-quality brewer's yeast. The main fermentation period of the young beer lasts between 4 and 6 days, during which the top fermented yeast rises to the surface and is skimmed off. The young beer is then sent to the filter cellar, and the fermentation tanks are cleaned in preparation for the next batch. The filter cellar is where all remaining cloudy substances are removed from the young beer. Up to 70,000 liters of beer can be filtered every hour along two highly modern filtering lines. For this purpose, a candle filter system, as well as a plate and frame filter system, are used. In keeping with the traditional process for bottled fermentation, fresh wort and bottom fermented pure brewer's yeast are then added after filtration. The young beer is now ready for bottling. Incoming empty bottles are carefully checked and cleaned on two highly modern bottling lines. Large bottle washing machines are used for this purpose. The bottles are cleaned in an alkaline bath at different water temperatures and then sent for bottling. The clean bottles pass along conveyor belts until they reach the two bottling lines. Here, they are filled with beer under pressure, and then the crown cork is inserted before the beer begins to froth. Up to 170,000 bottles can be filled in just 1 hour at the bottling unit. The bottles of beer then pass along more conveyor belts for quadruple labeling. Before the bottles arrive for storage in the computer-controlled warehouse, they need to be packed in the typically red crates of Ed Weissbräu. The crates are then transported on underground conveyor belts into the adjoining warehouse. Our Erdinger Weissbier only matures directly in its container, which is the bottle. At any one time, up to 15 million bottles of Erdinger Weissbier can be maturing in our computer-controlled and precisely air-conditioned high-rise warehouse. All of them are guaranteed to produce the same unmistakable taste. The process of bottled fermentation lasts between 3 and 4 weeks. Our warehouse computer makes sure that nothing is forgotten and automatically removes the required volumes once the prescribed period of storage is over. Any volumes for export are labeled at a special repackaging unit, packed into boxes and stored separately. The pallets are taken automatically from the warehouse and prepared for loading. Large forklift trucks are used to load the pallets on lorries. Each day, almost 1 million bottles of beer leave our warehouse. Erdinger Weissbier is distributed throughout the world and is delivered using a sophisticated system of transport logistics. With an annual output of over 1.3 million hectoliters of beer, 350 staff and an international distribution network, the brewery at the gates of Munich is the largest brewer of Weissbier in the world.
Schmeckt uns beim Dodo.